And again, it's a credit to the Cornell kids. I mean, you know, they came off a tough loss against Columbia last week, and I know the quarterback was banged up and some of their kids were hurt, and I thought they played very, very well. So we knew it was going to be hard. And every time we come up here, we know it's going to be hard. And so we're trying to tell our kids, and we came in beat up, and, you know, kudos to Andrew for stepping up in Billy's place and, you know, did a great job, and we made just enough plays on defense to kind of hold on against a very explosive, talented team. So, you know, it's tough. I mean, nothing's easy in this league, especially on the road, and, you know, kudos to our kids for making enough plays, but I certainly think, you know, the a lot of credit should be given to the way Cornell played as well, because I thought they played pretty well. They scared the living hell out of you, to be honest with you.
Brandon, this year's going to be your third Ivy title in 4 years, but just this season and the game has been up and down constantly. Even that final drive, like it seemed like you stopped Cornell a few times and there was that flag. What was going through your mind there every time? You thought the game was over? And
yeah, I mean, kind of echoing Coach in terms of you know, I guess it wouldn't be us if we didn't make it interesting. you know, obviously I would like to have the game over a lot sooner, but I'm just happy we got away with the win. And, you know, now it feels good. You know, now we can, you know, actually look back and reflect on our year. And, you know, it's a credit to guys like Andrew, everyone, all the seniors in the locker room, and this entire team, how we stepped up over the past month. And just no matter what people said about us, no matter, you know, who didn't believe, we all in that locker room believed, and look at us now, I guess.
That's right. Andrew, head into that final drive, someone else just tied up, what's going
through your mind? Well, all we needed was a field goal, because it was tied, and there was a short kickoff, so we got pretty good field position, so we were actually pretty calm in the huddle. All we needed was 30, 40 yards to get Loftus in field goal range, so we weren't really thinking touchdown, but we were able to move the ball and get down there, and it was great to get the touchdown.
Coach, the running game wasn't great in the first half. Cornell defense was doing some good things.
Yes, they were.
But with the 55-yard touchdown there by Lyle on the first possession of the second half, it sort of seemed to loosen up the offense, and from there you're able to sort of wear them down in the running game. Can you talk about that a little bit?
Yeah, they did a great job schematically. They kept flipping gaps, and I don't know if our kids weren't reading it correctly, because we weren't getting real crisp blocks coming off the line of scrimmage. We weren't getting as much movement as we thought we might be able to get. And in halftime, we kind of made some adjustments. We challenged our kids to play a little bit sounder, a little bit harder, a little bit more physical. And you know, luckily they stepped up and we were finally able to establish a running game, because we really did not establish a running game in that entire first half. It was kind of a couple big plays via the pass, and that was it. Some sporadic other plays, but it was not as consistent as, you know, we had hoped that we would be.
Andrew, I know Billy was here for the game. Did you have anything to say? Where's the wisdom for you before the game?
Yeah, we actually roomed together last night for the final time. We've always been roommates on away trips, and you were just telling me to do your thing, play the way you play, and lead the offense, and we're going to get the W, and that's exactly what happened to that.
I mean, I think just the fashion and the way we came back from, like I said, a month ago. You know, the season starting off with a loss to Lafayette, you know, a loss against Villanova. I think we were, 1-4 for a minute. And I said it a week ago. Jeff Jack, when we all, after that loss to Yale, we all sat in the locker room together as the seniors. And Jeff Jack said, you know, we've won championships outright before. We've swept the Ivy League two times, actually, as a senior class. But this one would be that much sweeter if we could come back and, you know, run the table from there on out. And, I mean, to be honest with you, he was right. You know, it wasn't easy. It wasn't, you know, perfect. It wasn't pretty at all. But, you know, just the senior guys in that locker room, we all led practice from that day on. We were hard on each other. We were definitely the hardest on each other, and we tried to play, you know, practice perfect so that we could play even better on game day. And I think you see a turn from that, after that Yale game. I think you see a huge turn in our team in terms of energy, in terms of aggressiveness, and that's what makes this one that much sweeter, because like I said before, our team could have went, like I think Coach Bagnoli used the word, our team could have splintered a while ago. But we all stayed together and we came stronger and closer, that much close knit. It weren't too many easy wins, and we weren't blowing teams out this year, but we were gritting it and fighting it out. And so 30 years from now, we'll all remember the season as a testament of, you know, as long as you believe, anything is possible, literally. So.
Coach,
yeah.
Your team dominated the third quarter and it looked like you might just ride out the game pretty easy from there. What changed going into the fourth quarter?
Yeah, I mean, we gave up some, you know, plays, big plays, and I'm certainly capable of making them, but, you know, we just got to do a better job on those third and 20s and fourth and 11s. And we were really one play away from being able to really wind the clock down and making it where everything was going to be a hurry up. And we were just, to their credit, we were never able to get that final play that would have got them out of sequence and then got them out of being comfortable that they could stay in their offense. And, you know, some of the credit's them. I like to see us do a little bit better in those scenarios. You know, so we'll have to look at the film to see exactly what happened. But we were just like a play away from being able to really kind of get control of it. And then that way we can run the clock. We can do some things that will minimize the amount of damage that a pretty potent offense can do against us. But we just never were able to make that play.
Can you come into the season with a third quarterback
in the depth chart? Could you imagine that you would have been the starting quarterback in the final game? Yeah, it's pretty hard to believe. Yeah, it's a pretty cool experience, you know. Coming into the season, you know, you got all these great athletes at quarterback. And you're just trying to work every day to be the best you can be, and you never know when your number's going to be called. And when it actually did get called, I was ready for the moment. You know, Coach Bagnoli's been giving me a lot of reps in practice, a lot of reps in games. And, you know, I just give all the credit to my teammates for the way we finished this game, and it's really an honor to be a part of this class.
Coach, you've always, you know, put a big attention to the time when Billy was starting, and do you think that definitely paid off today?
Yeah, again, it was a calculated plan that we had. Just, again, we didn't anticipate Billy getting hurt to this extent, but, you know, you have always an issue with twisted ankles, bruised knees, when you play the style that Billy plays. I mean, I've been telling you every week, he is going to take some hits, not only throwing the ball, but being part of our run game and being scrambling off the pass play. So to hedge our bets, we better have somebody. So it is the fourth quarter of Harvard, and we're not bringing in somebody who's never been in the game. We're saying, okay, go lead us on the game-winning touchdown drive. You know, we've had confidence in him. He's executed. He's blended in. Kids believe in him. And so it paid off in dividends last week in the fourth quarter against Harvard, and it paid off this week, you know, the entire game against Cornell.
Anything else, guys?
Coach, this is nine your 21 seasons.
Yeah.
Not that you want to share any of them, but for a team like Cornell who's never won any, what would you say is the number one thing for building the championship program?
I think their blueprint, I think, is very good. I mean, to be honest with you, I think they're certainly going in the right direction, and the league is getting more and more competitive every year. You kind of look at some of those teams that last year struggled, and all of a sudden you saw a resurgence with Princeton. You know, you go back 3 or 4 years and you saw a resurgence with Cornell. And now you saw what Columbia's capable of doing it. And you saw what Dartmouth now all of a sudden is. And so the league continues to just get more and more aggressive. And I think the things they're doing make sense. You know, I certainly think this is, we don't have an easy out in our league. Whereas maybe 5, 6, 7 years ago, there were a couple games. You say, these are going to be winnable games even if we don't play well. Now you can't even dream of saying that. So I think the blueprint's in place. It's always trying to get good players and have them buy into your system, but it always starts with the players and starts with the chemistry and the leadership. And, you know, you put a lot of good people in that locker room who work hard and believe in themselves, and good things can happen.
Thanks a lot, guys.
All right, thank you.